Museums, and particularly natural history museums, are places where three things happen. The first is we do basic scientific research. We discover things. We do excavations and expeditions. And the production of new knowledge creates objects that we house in collections. And many people think that museums have collections just for display. But the fact is that museums are actually the warehouses of our culture's knowledge. What we have learned in the last 300 years is stored in three-dimensional form in museums. And then, of course, sharing that knowledge and those objects with anybody who wants to come. And this is a very open, egalitarian idea that knowledge isn't just for the ivy-covered buildings and college campuses. Knowledge is for anybody who has any curiosity at all. My name's Kirk Johnson. I'm the Sant Director at the National Museum of Natural History at the Smithsonian Institution in Washington, D.C. I'm also Amherst class of 1982, where I was a geology and fine arts major. One of the real reasons I went to Amherst was that Amherst had not only an art museum, but it actually had a geology museum. And that's almost unique in the colleges of North America. And I walked into the Pratt Museum in that spring. I was like, oh, I am home. This place is awesome. And for 4 years, I had this key that would open the doors in the basement, and I'd go down at night after a party and just carefully write out labels and catalog fossils late into the night. One of the things that's so important about the Natural History Museum is that it tells the story not only of our planet, but it tells the story of the last couple hundred years when we've been collecting our planet. We've changed and appropriated much of the world's natural landscapes, and now we're beginning to affect things like the chemistry of the oceans, the temperature of the atmosphere, and all of that, that entire arc of change is documented by what we have collected during that time period. So these two narratives, the long history of the planet Earth, and the shorter narrative of humans' recent rapid expansion on that planet and their impact on that planet, to give us a deep pool of examples of what can happen on the planet and also what we've done, and those things together tell us, well, here's some options to think about for the future. And the future is coming at us very rapidly. We have tools to keep up with the change in the future if we articulate it with what's happened in the past. And that, to me, is the value of history.